Pacific is the third book about the residents of a place called Grouse County in the rural Midwest. And in Pacific, there's a young man named Micah who leaves the rural Midwest to go live with his mother, who is a TV actress in Los Angeles. And in Los Angeles, he finds a kind of wildlife that he is really not ready to handle. He falls in love with a much more experienced woman. He does new drugs. He gets a little bit too much into drinking. He gets thrown out of his prep school. And in the end, he is more or less living on the beach. And it's a book in a way about siblings, because his sister is back in the Midwest, and she has told him when he left, if you ever need help, call me. And at sort of the nearing the end of the book, he calls her, and she comes to, although I guess I'm giving the plot away, but she comes to Los Angeles to sort of rescue him and get him back on the right track. And at the same time that I say his life is kind of failing, he's also having a really great time. And the other kids in Los Angeles are kind to him and welcome him in. But it doesn't save him sort of from the pain and loneliness of being a teenager essentially away from home. And then meanwhile, back in his home, there is a stranger has come to town, a young woman named Sandra Zalma, who seems to believe that she is a warrior from Celtic mythology who is searching for a certain rock called the Leofail. And she turns out to be quite dangerous and is involved in a crime. And in a way, so when I think about it, I think it's a little bit about leaving home, because when Micah leaves home and goes to Los Angeles, he has his adventures there. But he is essentially, this is the process of growing up for him. For Sandra Zalma, she comes from out of town. She leaves her home and comes to Grouse County. And instead of growing up, she kind of retreats into a fantasy world that makes her rather dangerous. And then all the people that Micah knew have to deal with her. And that's basically what happens in the novel. It's like part paranormal, part love story, part coming of age, part crime, you know, humor, sadness. One of the main characters loses her mother. So there's many things going on in this novel. Sandra Zalma. I was in Manhattan and down by St. Mark's Place, and I saw a very tall woman with short platinum hair crossing the street, and I said, okay, that's Sandra. So I started with, you know, just, and I don't know who she is, but I just started with that sort of physical character. And then I knew that she believes she's after this rock, which may or may not exist. And so it was, I wanted her to be very serious about her mission, just as the people in the Celtic sagas are. And in a way that an average person would just be wondering, what? Okay, I guess so. You're looking for a rock. Well, there's lots of rocks, you know. So it was through her, you know, usually I learn about a character by making dialogue and letting them talk and hearing what they say. I don't usually have a set format that, oh, I know exactly who this is going to be and what they're going to do. I start writing and I see what they do, and that's how I find out. I would say the way that Grouse County came about was, first of all, when I was growing up and first got access to cars and driving, you know, I could go around in the rural area where I lived, and it seemed like every 6 or 7 miles there was a little town. Some of them were really little, some of them were not quite so little, but they were all pretty small towns. And there was a kind of constellation of them. And we would go from one to another, and, you know, just to see what was there. And so in writing The End of Vandalism, which is the first book in, of the trilogy, that Pacific is the last book so far, I would write about all these towns, and I made up all these towns because I was aware of this kind of sort of cluster of towns as a way of sort of, you know, topographical arrangement. And so it was interesting, as writing stories for the end of vandalism that appeared in The New Yorker. And after several of these stories, the fact checker said, I need a map, because you're talking about all these towns and I need to know exactly where they are so I can check and make sure that you're being consistent. So I basically drew one out, and that map has appeared in many of the books. It was actually drawn by my wife, who's an artist, and it's in, you know, it's been published in many different translations, and showing the map in that world. And I like the ability to sort of recreate a world of small towns. And then also, when, you know, I'm writing about Los Angeles, I'm also drawing on the things that I remember from there, such as Topanga Canyon, or a rooftop party in the Toy District in downtown Los Angeles, or the top of Mount Wilson, where there's a famous observatory. So I use these kind of physical, sort of markers to create a space in which the characters can operate.